parents, and despite everything, we'd never given up. We never had a perfect life. Our parents were horrible. One of our brothers died, and we were kicked out with nothing left. We were taken in by rich and good people, and learned that life isn't always at its best. It can get harder too. But that was 3 months ago. I'm Evie. My older brother died, and now I have to deal with being the oldest. It's pretty hard, considering I have 9 siblings. And it's also scary. I don't know if I can be the responsible person they want me to be. Now meet my family.
There's Elaine. Her and I share the same parents. She acts like a tomboy a little, and she's super fun, and also probably my favorite. She's still telling anyone else that I said that. That's Jeanette, or Jeannie, as I sometimes call her. Like with most of my siblings, we don't share the same dad, but it doesn't bother me. She's pretty cool and really fun.
That's Sarah.
She's really sassy and doesn't care what other people think. She's been really lonely with the boys, though. Her dream would be for us girls to live together again.
Charlie's cool. He's not annoying, and I never really see him anymore because he works on different floors, so he's better than others. I miss him, but it's what it is.
His name's Zach. My only other full sibling. Sadly, like Charlie, I rarely ever see him anymore. He's really silly though, and always a blast to hang out with. I wish I saw him more, maybe someday. There's Milo. He's quiet and tiny, but sometimes he can be crazy. He loves swimming and anything that has sugar in it. He's also extremely messy. Half the messes he cleans are probably from him.
CJ might be my favorite brother. He's kind of clingy, but very sweet and cute. Being the youngest, I had to protect him the most. But now we live on opposite floors, which again, sucks.
Oh, he's Carlos. He never has a shirt on and can get pretty annoying. But seriously, he never has a shirt on. Like, he's also probably my least favorite brother, but he doesn't need to know that either.
And there's Jake. He's besties with Carlos and Charlie. They're lucky to have a floor together. He's also really nice and loves to play games with his brothers.
Attention everyone in this house, there's a family dinner upstairs in 10 minutes. Don't be late. Repeat. Attention everyone in this house, there's a family dinner in 10 minutes upstairs.
Here's the announcement. Everyone must go to their assigned floors with no interactions with others.
If you get out of line one time and interact, first thing that happens is you lose all your food. You do it twice, you're out of this house.
Woohoo!
All right, now go to your rooms.
Yay! Make it snappy.
Back and right.
try. Me, Ellie, and the littles figured out that we can communicate through the vents, but we might get caught being more supervised. So let's try this.
Sincerely, Ellie.
So, what is it?
I found a way to communicate with them.
How?
The ventilation system.
How did you find this out?
Well, I was sweeping by this vent, and I heard them talking.
Who's that?
The Lells.
What about the others?
I don't know. I've never heard of that connected to them.
Well, how are we going to talk to them if we aren't sure?
Well, I found another way to communicate, but it's more hard.
Well, tell us.
It's putting notes into the laundry. Carlos does the laundry, so obviously he'll get the notes.
But how do we know if he gets them?
I don't know. He might send them back, but hard to tell.
But what if we wanted to talk to, like, others on Carlos's floor?
We could address them to Carlos's.
I'm sure that Carlos would probably show them to the others.
Yeah.
I'm sure Jake and Charlie want to know what's going on, too. Yeah. We should try it. And if we get caught, we can just say it was an accident.
I think the laundry thing would be better for the older kid, because vets, you're gonna get caught at some point.
They're way too obvious, especially since I think the littles have one on the floor.
Yeah. And if the parents hear them talking to them, we're out.
For good. Well, first, we'll be deprived of food, but either is bad. We're already getting this. So, now we can escape, right? Like, this could be our way.
Yeah, but we need to figure out a plan, which is why I tried to figure out ways to communicate with them. If we can communicate them, then we can all form a plan that we all know.
Well, first of all, before we try to leave this house, we're gonna need supplies. Food.
Water.
Blankets. We can't just
money at all.
And how are we gonna like carry all of this too? I don't think they have any backpacks sliding around here. I say we go in groups. Groups of us escape, and then the others can cover for us.
Yeah.
We can try it. And I say the littles first. I mean, they're the youngest. They go before us. Yeah. And
if
I
anything,
think the parents would believe them if they lied.
Yeah. If anything, the littles are the ones that aren't really supervised that much anyway.
True. We're more supervised. That means we go last.
Yeah.
We should talk to them about this.
Maybe. Tomorrow. It's late. Let's go to bed. Yeah.
What are you guys doing?
Cleaning the vents. Look.
They are clean.
Well, we did a good job.
Here's your bars.
There's two, but there's...
Just split them and deal with it.
Sarah, Milo, CJ, Zach, are you there?
Yeah, it's me, Zach, and CJ. Is that you?
Yeah, I'm here. I don't really know what we can do, but we really need to plan something to escape.
Someone's working in there though, so this is the best we have.
We're lucky we even have a bedroom.
Well, it's not like this tiny little bed fits the three of us.
Which is why we always trade off sleeping on the floor.
We need to focus on the plan.
Yeah.
What are we gonna do? Like, sneaking the food, the water, the money, the blankets? That's gonna It's gonna be so risky.
Like we said, the littles have to go first.
Yeah, but how are we gonna get them the food? The laundry in? I feel like that would be way more obvious than a letter.
Yeah. Maybe we could, go out by one by one, each carrying an amount until we can find an orphan or something.
Or we could find out a way that we could get to the other floors, like make up an excuse on why we would need to leave this floor to do our job.
Well, that's gonna be hard, considering the new rule.
Yeah, but it's the best we have. This is the floor with all the food, and we're the only ones who can get it.
That's true. We need to find a way to bring it to them, and I feel like if we just go to another floor, it's gonna be way too obvious.
We should talk to Evie more about this.
Good idea.
Oh, you're back?
Yeah, I got some food, goldfish, and bars. And actually, I found a backpack, which, you know, really helpful.
Surprising.
Yeah. I was gonna put that there, but...
How are we gonna get to them?
Yeah, it's a problem. I would say laundry, but, like, this is way more obvious than a little note, like we said before.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe we can, like...
Are there any larger vents?
No, I don't think so.
No, I don't think so.
We could maybe try to do more laundry.
The windows.
Windows?
Well, we could tie the backpack to a string and launch out the window.
I don't think these windows open.
What about the balconies? Like the stairs outside the balcony. Maybe they can meet there. We can tell them in a note to meet us there all in the balconies.
We could.
Yeah. The balconies.
But only one of us could go. We don't want to make it too obvious that we're not here.
We can just tell.
And how are we going to hide the backpack to get out there?
True. We could just wrap it up in a blanket or something.
Yeah.
And then bring it outside.
Like, say we're doing a chore.
Yeah, because like sometimes we hang the wet towels outside.
And we have to dust the balcony anyway, so.
Or like clean out there.
Yeah.
So.
We could. We'll tie a string to that and send it down.
Okay.
The littles obviously have to be first.
We'll have to tell them about it too. We need to write another little too.
And if we can, we can take it to them ourselves. Mm-hmm. All right, well, I guess that's settled. Meeting adjourned.
Guys, I just got laundry from the others. Let's see if they wrote back.
Hey, I'm sweeping. Move.
Bad.
I found a letter.
What's it say?
Hi, I got your letter and I think communicating with the vets is smart, but also risky, just like writing this letter. The owners told me I have to speak the walker today after lunch around 12:45. If y'all have any chores outside, or if you can get one around the time, meet me around the walkway so we can talk. It'll be brief and quick, but hopefully we can get some sort of a plan ready. P.S. Beware. He probably will have no shirt on.
No shirt on? Seriously?
Typical Carlos.
Wait, Jeanette, don't you have to do the chores today?
I think so, yeah.
Well, you can meet him.
Alright. Around that time, I'll see if the trash is full and then I'll ask if I can take it out.
Okay, cool.
Nice.
But here's the thing. We should try to get the food to him too so we can give it to Little's, but... They'll probably have me take the elevator since still no traction, and those have security cameras.
True.
So how am I gonna sneak it to him?
Why don't you put the food in the trash bag?
Alright. How to do that without getting caught?
You take two trash bags.
I
one with the trash and one with the food.
We could probably do it in here.
Yeah.
Alright. So, after lunch then.
You mean you haven't done that yet? I thought I told you to do that an hour ago. Yes, take out the trash.
Hi, it's good to see you again.
Hey, what's up?
Yeah, I brought this for the littles to try to get this to them.
Okay.
We need to escape and step one is supplies. There's some food in there for them.
I agree. Are we all?
Yeah, but we don't really have a plan yet. That's our main problem.
Darn it.
So,
how are we going to get out?
We're working on that. But we'll keep you updated through the vents or we'll send you letters.
Amy, where's Jenna?
She was taking out the trash, remember?
Jeanette!
Go.
What's taking so long?
I was taking out the trash. I'll be up.
Get over. Drop.
They sent us all this food.
Whoa, what's this?
Sarah, Milo, CJ, and Zach. Keep this food safe until we're ready to escape. Your older siblings. Let's try to find a safe place for us. Yeah, let's go.
Aline! Aline, you're still sick? Come on, we just hit the last letter, call us in the littles. You know about the plan?
Oh, that's what I forgot! See, like, last night I remembered I forgot something, but then I forgot it, so I couldn't remember that I forgot it, so then I went to bed knowing that I forgot something, but it's really complicated because I forgot it! Oh, right,
okay. Okay. Come on, get up. We need to finalize the plan.
Okay, so just as a review, we're gonna ask the cook a lunch or dinner. Hopefully they'll say yes. And then while we're cooking or while we're serving them dinner, then, Aline, you gotta listen.
Pay attention.
And then while we do that, then they'll escape. And then after they do that, then they'll come back for us and we'll escape, right?
Mm-hmm. And so the littles,
come back for us.
Yeah, the littles have the food. We can try to grab money on our way out, and then the boys will get blankets, so we'll have all the supplies we need. And the woods right out there will be perfect. I'm sure there's a road somewhere around here, and we can find ourselves a better home.
But what's our plan?
We just went over this.
What's our plan after we escape?
I guess
find an orphanage.
Hitchhike?
Never have parents again.
Orphanage. Finding a better home. Foster care. Whatever works. We just need to get out of here.
We really need an orphanage though.
Okay, Liam. Let's just go get you some breakfast so you'll wake up.
Oh, I don't want to go up.
Well, you guys need to
go up.
Do I want you to cook lunch? Of course I want you to cook lunch. Don't you always cook me lunch?
What should we make up for lunch?
How about we just eat a bus?
The kids are gone!
What? Okay, get in there and think about what you've done.
Evie!
No!
Good. You guys made it.
Wait, where's Evie?
She didn't make it.
Still need you.
We all need to get out of here.
Let me take
your head, I'll make you right. I swear to love you all my life.
I don't wanna go up.
Hold on.
Wait, Daddy,
I still
no.
need you. Long in this highway, you're silent beside me. Driving a nightmare I can't escape from. Helplessly praying, the light isn't fading. Hiding the shock and the chill in my bones. Took you away on table. We pace back and forth as you lay still. I pull you in to feel your heartbeat. Can you hear me screaming, please don't leave me. Hold on, I still want you. Come back, I still need you. Let me take your hand, I'll make you right. I swear to love you all my life. Hold on, I still need you. I just wanna hear you saying, baby, let's go home. Let's go home. Yeah, I just wanna take you home. Hold on, I still want you. Come back, I still need you.